Are you considering joining Mintos again, or do you perhaps think of starting investing on Mintos as a new investor? Well, a few days ago, we asked our community here on YouTube whether you would be interested in an updated review of Mintos. The majority of you have responded that you are interested to see whether Mintos is worth it in 2021. So in this video, we will dive deeper into some of the recent developments of the platform and look at the currently available offers to give you an idea of whether Mintos is worth it. My name is Jakub from P2P Empower, and if your goal is to become a more educated P2P investor, consider subscribing and hit the notification bell to see more videos like this in the future. So, if you are new to P2P lending, Mintos is the largest P2P marketplace for loans in Europe. It is a Latvian company founded in 2015 and currently serving more than 440,000 investors. By investing in Mintos, you are funding loans from various lenders. It is important to understand that Mintos is not a loan originator, but a middleman between you and the lending company. By investing in loans on Mintos, you can expect an interest of up to 10% per year. In this video, we will go over some of the most important events that happened in the last 1.5 years that may have an impact on your performance on Mintos. So Mintos was the first P2P marketplace, and it was the first platform that I've joined back in 2017. From 2017 to 2019, Mintos has produced very reliable annual returns of 11 or 12%. Back then, there were barely any defaults and the platform was fairly easy to use. 3 years ago, there were significantly fewer loan originators in which you could invest manually or with the older version of the auto-invest. The buyback guarantee has worked very well and there were no pending payments or a grace period. The investor base on Mintos has been, however, increasing gradually, and Mintos had to provide more loans to remain relevant in the P2P lending space, which is why the company has onboarded new lenders to increase the loan availability. The platform introduced improvements of the auto-invest, where you could define the diversification settings. Mintos also invented the Mintos ratings, which was an older version of the Mintos risk score. Later on, Mintos also started offering the invest and access feature, which aimed to copy the benefits of Bondora's Go and Grow, but with a higher yield. The fact is that Mintos has grown rapidly until 2020, when the pandemic started. In the first half of 2020, Mintos suspended multiple lending companies and locked over 120 million of investors' assets, despite the promise of the buyback guarantee. The company also introduced pending payments and funds in recovery, which had a negative impact on the liquidity and performance of your portfolio. Since then, Mintos managed to recover over 50 million euro of investors' money, which is certainly something that many investors appreciate. The platform is also monthly sending an overview of the funds in recovery and hosting a quarterly livestream where they cover the latest developments surrounding the status of recoveries. Currently, there are around 68 million of investors' funds still in recovery. The time will tell how much of investors' funds can be recovered. One of the biggest criticisms against Mintos is that a large number of suspended companies are owned by one of the biggest shareholders of Mintos itself, Igor Skessenfelds. In fact, currently 36 million out of the 68 million of funds in recovery are from lenders that are owned by this shareholder, which is more than 50%. It would be certainly a good sign if Mintos manages to recover all of the loans from lenders that are in one way or another connected to shareholders of Mintos, to prove that a conflict of interest doesn't have a negative impact on investors. In 2021, Mintos also got their investment firm brokerage license that changes the structure of your investments on Mintos. You will no longer be investing in individual loan assignments, but in notes, which are basically 6 to 20 loans with similar properties bundled together. Currently, Mintos is transitioning from the old to the new structure, which may take up to 1 year. Mintos has published a few detailed articles on their website, so if you want to get more insights into how notes work, I suggest you study the guides and familiarize yourself with the terms before you invest in notes. After the transition period, Mintos will be operating as a platform regulated by Latvian authorities. The really only tangible benefit for investors is that the risk of Mintos being a scam is significantly reduced. All the other risks associated with investing in loans still remain the same. In short, the Latvian IBF license is more useful for platforms rather than investors. If you want to learn more about it, check out this video here where you can learn all there is to know about the investment firm brokerage license. The challenges in 2020 brought some changes in lenders that are listing loans on Mintos. Few lenders like Capitalia, Cream Finance or Stickredit left the platform to fund its loan book with their own P2P lending site. A few others have repaid all loans and exited the platform. One of the largest lenders, Mogo, has also bought Sibo from the defaulted Finco Group, as well as two other lenders, Tigo and Credo. A few lenders have also changed their names. GetBucks Kenya is now TrustGo, and GetBucks in South Africa changed the name to Smart Advance. And Mogo also rebranded the finance group to Eleving Group. After the turbulent previous year, Mintos has onboarded many new lenders from Mexico. There are also new lenders from Russia, Uganda, Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, or the UK. Alright, so that was a short overview of the most recent news. What's worth looking into is also the outstanding portfolio. As you can see, Mintos' monthly outstanding portfolio is still lower than before the pandemic. What's also interesting is to see the numbers of loans listed on the primary and on the secondary market. This gives you an idea about how many loans are available and how many investors are selling their investments. So, what is it like to invest in Mintos now at the end of 2021? And what has changed? Well, regardless if you're a new investor or an already registered user, you have to resubmit some of your personal information and also pass the suitability and appropriateness test. If you don't pass the test, some of the features like Mintos strategies or the auto invest will not be available for you. What you are left with is the option to invest manually, which can be very confusing, especially if you are just starting out with P2P lending. Keep in mind that if you don't pass the test, you won't be categorized as a retail investor, and perhaps investing on Mintos is just not the right fit for you. While it is quite annoying to do the test, as now every regulated platform in Latvia is requiring it, I think it certainly helps to assess whether you have the required knowledge in order to invest in loans. After passing the test, you have the option to either choose one of the predefined strategies or create your own alternate strategy or invest even manually. So let's go over the options that are currently available to you. First, you can choose the diversified strategy. This is basically the updated Invest and Access, which is a former feature that actually invested in pretty much everything that was available without any diversification settings. Now, this updated strategy has been adapted to limit your exposure into lender to a maximum of 15%. While this is an improvement, keep in mind that all lenders will be considered here, even those with low risk scores. Based on my previous experience with Mintos, I would not recommend this option. The second investment strategy, which is called conservative, limits your exposure in lenders to a maximum of 15%, invests in only lenders with a risk score between 7 and 10, as well as those lenders with the highest portfolio quality and at least 80% of current loans. This is by far the best strategy for passive investors, as Mintos takes into consideration the portfolio quality, which is likely the most important aspect that directly reflects the risk of your invested funds. The first strategy that Mintos is suggesting is the high yield strategy, that is investing in the top 60% of loans with the highest interest. This means that you will expose your portfolio to many emerging markets and new lenders that aren't as established yet. I think that the promised return for this strategy does not justify the additional risk, which is hard to evaluate for anyone who is new to P2P lending. If you would have to recommend a strategy, the conservative strategy would be most likely the most suitable one. What's worth mentioning is that those three strategies also promise instant cash out, which is not always going to work during unusual market conditions or when a lender in which you have invested is suspended. What you should also pay attention to is the expected yield by choosing one of those strategies. This yield is changing according to the currently available loans, but it is currently between 6.5 and 8%, which is not that much when compared to some of the other options on the market with an excellent track record during 2020 and beyond. All right, the last option to invest on Mintos is by creating a custom automated strategy. This strategy promises returns of up to 19% per year. Keep in mind that those high interest loans are limited by their amount as well as the loan term. We recommend reviewing the currently available loans on any P2P lending site to get an idea about the loans that you are funding. Alright, so the custom automated strategy allows you to choose the lending company, the country risk, risk score, loan type, and the buyback obligation. You can also choose whether you want to invest in only currently loans without pending payments. Some additional filter options are also the investment structures, amortization period, or the borrower APR. Don't forget to set up your interest rate, loan term, investment amount per loan, as well as your diversification settings. Before you finalize your settings, check the matching results to see whether there are even loans available that fit your strategy. Keep in mind that the loan availability is limited, and if your strategy doesn't fit the listed loans, you will suffer from cash drag, which means that your money remains uninvested and you won't earn any interest on it. The custom automated strategy is certainly more suitable for advanced investors who want want to control the exposure in certain lenders. If you are just starting out with smaller amounts, the benefits of the custom strategy are rather limited. So if you're a passive investor, the conservative strategy is likely the most suitable option. If you're an experienced investor with large investment portfolio, you might want to consider the custom automated strategy and fine-tune your portfolio settings. In any case, keep in mind that there are various risks associated with investing in loans. The buyback obligation is not an insurance, and the promise of instant liquidity is also not guaranteed. So, what are now the main takeaways from this video and what you should expect from Mintos in late 2021? Mintos is regulated, but until the company starts listing notes, everything remains the same as it was before, with the difference that now you have to provide additional information and pass the suitability test. The return on Mintos is significantly lower than on other P2P lending sites. Most of the loans are being offered at 7% interest. This is mainly due to the high availability of cheap funding sources for lenders rather than necessarily higher securities for investors. Bigger lenders are frequently issuing bonds and repurchase more expensive loans from investors, which again lowers your interest. If you want to invest on Mintos, you should still research the lenders, check their financial reports, and be picky about the countries in which you are investing. Keep in mind that there is still around 68 million in recovery, which is around 15% of the outstanding loan book. Mintos has already recovered quite a lot of money, and this is by no means easy job. You should, however, not expect a full recovery, as this is very rare in the P2P lending space. On a positive note, Mintos is improving its products. The auto-invest as well as the automated strategies and risk scores are constantly improving. The statistics page is also quite comprehensive, which cannot be said about every P2P platform on the market. So, is it worth it investing on Mintos again? Well, I believe it's a question of the ratio between risk and return, as well as your experience and investment preference. Personally, I can still earn more than 10% interest on many other smaller platforms that have a better track record. If you are happy with an annual yield of 7%, then Mintos can be an option to consider. The choice is clearly yours. If you want to learn more about Mintos and follow up on the latest developments, have a look at our in-depth Mintos review. And if you are looking for alternatives, you can also dive deeper into our academy section to compare various other options with higher returns. So that's been our take on the current developments on Mintos. Let me know in the comments below what's your position towards Mintos today. Do you think it's worth it? Thanks for watching, and I will catch you in the next video.